can get over 500 women to take a beautiful afternoon and devote it to science, and specifically to women in science, you know you've hit on a winning combination.
It's really the first of its kind in the country to try and connect women with science.
It's just really exciting to be able to show the general public some of the fabulous advances that are being made in biological science today in the U.S. and is really the message that we want to get across to the supporters of the university and the public in general.
The playing field is still not level for women, and supporting them at the early stages of their career can make all the difference in the world.
It's really important to support young investigators, especially young women investigators, because we're so underrepresented in the sciences.
The more people understand what goes on at a place like Rockefeller University, I think the better off we'll all be.
Now we need a bigger hall, because we want more people to know about what women are doing and what Rockefeller is doing. And this is a great showcase.
The approach that many women in and at our university take in terms of doing their science, their ability to convey information, the rigor with which they do their science, the high expectations they set for the rest of us, I think this is really important.
We need to make sure that the avenues for advancement are open to all women in science, and that if they are worthy, they will be recognized and they will achieve what they are meant to achieve.
So excited to be here. Everyone looks and smells divine. Each of you will have a different set of receptors, which explains why there are big disagreements about if something smells good or bad and if it's strong or weak, because we're all a little bit different.
Since science and fragrance was Leslie's passion, I thought it would be really fun to introduce her to Frederick Malle, who's one of the most creative perfume manufacturers.
It's really nice to be able to see some of the women that support women's science at these types of luncheons and events over the past couple of years.
Almost every table has a woman scientist sitting with the guests. And there's a little write-up about the scientists.
And all of us go home knowing more and excited about the prospects of their work. The opportunity to be at a table to talk about the work that our scientists are doing is a very rare thing.
I admire all the women in the scientific field, and I think it's great to also inspire next generations of women. I think also science has been neglected a little bit, so I think it's a very, very important initiative.
Well, I'd like to thank all of the friends and the supporters of the university who were able to attend the Women in Science lecture and luncheon here today. It was a wonderful event and a wonderful opportunity for the women professionals, businesswomen, women in philanthropy, and other friends of the university to come together on this beautiful May day. Thank you.